Hi learners! Today, we will learn a new topic in physics. Are you ready? Let's start then. Physics is the branch of science that deals with the structure of matter, its motion, and behavior through space and time, and the related entities of energy and force. In this video lesson, you will be introduced to the following key terms: distance and displacement. At the end of this video lesson, you will be able to describe the motion of an object in terms of distance or displacement. When a person goes to his workplace, he should be able to cover a certain distance. And aside from that, he also said to cover his displacement with respect to original position or his home, which is usually taken as a reference point. But what is the difference between distance and displacement? That's what I will explain today. Distance refers to the length of path covered. Take a look at the illustration. If this is a person and she is going to her workplace, the entire path that she traveled is the distance she covered. Distance is said to be a scalar quantity. That means it's a measurement that has only magnitude but with no direction. For example, this person traveled 30 meters. What about displacement? Displacement is the shortest distance between the initial position and final position. Displacement is said to be a vector quantity, which means it's a measurement that has magnitude and direction. The displacement is defined as the change in position of an object. Another definition of displacement is, it is the shortest distance between the initial position and final position. For example, the displacement of the person here is 10 meters, but we still need to find the direction. We can find the direction using a compass. If the workplace is in this point, we can tell using the compass that the direction is southeast. Therefore, the displacement is 10 meters southeast. In addition to the direction in the compass, we need to know more specific direction, so we need to find the angle by using protractor. Here, we can see that the angle is 30 degrees. So to summarize, the displacement of the person from home to his workplace is 10 meters, 30 degrees to the southeast. Or you can write it in 10 meters, 30 degrees south to east. Alright, this time, let's try to solve this sample problem. A student walks 4 meters east and then walks 3 meters north. Determine the distance and displacement. Finding the distance is simple. We simply add the 4 meters and 3 meters. Since distance is a scalar quantity, we disregard the direction, meaning no need to write the direction. So the distance would be 7 meters. Let's proceed to the displacement. Remember, in the sample problem, the student walked 4 meters east and then walks 3 meters north. The displacement is the shortest distance between the point 1 and point 2, or the final point. In the illustration, it is represented by the broken lines. This looks familiar, right? Oh yes, it's a right triangle. Integrating math, to find the third side of a right triangle, we use the Pythagorean theorem. So c squared is equals to the sum of a squared plus b squared, where c is the hypotenuse of the triangle as represented by the broken lines. A and b are the legs of the triangle, and it can be interchanged. To find the value of c, we just need to find the square root of a squared plus b squared. Then, we substitute the value. A is equals to 4 squared and b is equal to 3 squared. Now, 4 squared is equal to 16 and 3 squared is equal to 9. Then, we add them and we find the square root of 25, which is 5 meters. We have now the magnitude. Since we are trying to find out the displacement, we still need to know the direction of the person. So in this sample, we will be using a compass. So as you can see, the direction in the compass is northeast. So to be more specific to direction, we need to measure the angle, and we will use the protractor. So the angle is approximately 63 degrees. Now we both have the distance and displacement. So distance, which is 7 meters, and the displacement, which is 5 meters, 63 degrees northeast. Alright, so here's another example. A hungry sheep goes wherever it finds a good grass to eat. It first goes 10 kilometers to the east, then it takes right turn and goes 5 kilometers to the south, and finally takes another right turn and goes 10 kilometers to the west. How far has this sheep traveled? Now let's try to answer this together. So in this question, you can actually get two valid answers, the distance and the displacement. So the total distance traveled, which is the total length of its path, in this illustration, the distance traveled is 10 kilometers, 5 kilometers, and 10 kilometers. And this will give you as 25 kilometers. So if that's what we came up with, what we calculated is the total distance traveled by the sheep. Now, how about the displacement? Take a look on the illustration. You will see that the shortest distance between starting point and end point would have been 5 kilometers to the south. It doesn't matter what it did along the way, what its path was. At the end of the day, it ended up to 5 kilometers south. And this notion is known as the displacement. Using a protractor, the angle is 90 degrees south. So your displacement is 5 kilometers 90 degrees south. Okay, to sum up what we have learned today, let us differentiate distance and displacement. Distance refers to the length of path covered. On the other hand, displacement is the shortest distance between the initial point and the final point. In short, it is the change in position. Distance is a scalar quantity, which means it's a measurement that has only magnitude but with no direction. While displacement is said to be a vector quantity, which means it's a measurement that has magnitude and direction. Alright, that's all for today. In our next video lesson, we will be discussing about speed and velocity. See you in our next video lesson. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and hit that notification icon for more videos like this. Bye everyone, and have a great day.